In this project, we'll build our very first AI agent. Agents are super cool. You can give an agent a task, and that agent will reason the steps that it needs to execute in order to achieve that goal. And some instructions might be simple. For example, we might ask an agent to go online, retrieve some data, and give us a response. But agents can also execute multiple steps. For example, we might ask the agent to go online, retrieve data, but then also store that data in a database. This is without a doubt one of the most important concepts to understand in 2025. So in this project, we'll build our very first research agent. And before we build this agent, let me explain one of the limitations we have with something like ChatGPT by using our ChatGPT clone. If I ask this large language model a question about recent data, it should tell us that it actually doesn't know. It doesn't have up-to-date information, like what is the current weather in New York? And we will get a response saying that the large language model can't answer our question because it can only answer questions from its training data. Now, the benefit of agents is that we can assign tools that will assist the agent in achieving its goal. For example, the ability to search real-time data online. Now, enough talk. Let's create our new chat flow. Let's give it a name like research agent. And now, instead of adding a chain to the canvas, we will now add an agent. And here we have a list of different agents, but the most commonly used agent is the tool agent. So with the tool agent, we can assign tools, of course, but we can also assign memory so that we can have a conversation with this agent. And of course, we need to assign a chat model. Let's start with the chat model then. Under add nodes, let's go to chat models, and I'll assign the chat OpenAI model. Let's attach a chat node to our agent. I'll select my credentials. For the model name, I'm actually going to switch over to GPT-4o, and this is because agents are slightly more complicated than simple chatbots. Agents do a lot of reasoning behind the scenes to figure out which tasks need to be executed in which sequence and which tools should be called in order to achieve this goal. Therefore, I do recommend selecting an intelligent model for all the projects going forward. I'll set the temperature as 0.6, and let's also go ahead and add our memory node. So on the memory, let's select the buffer window memory node. Let's attach it to our agent, and we'll change the size to 20 messages. Now, before we add any tools, let's save this flow. Then in the chat window, let's simply send a message like hello, just to make sure everything is working. Great. Now this agent still won't be able to answer up-to-date information. For instance, what is the current date and time? It will tell us that it actually doesn't know because we haven't assigned any tools to assist the agent yet. So what we can do is go to add nodes, and under tools, we get a list of ready-to-use tools like Brave Search API, we've got a calculator tool, the chain tool, which allows us to create a chain within this project and call that as a tool. Or we can use the chatflow tool to call other chatflows as tools. We can also execute code using the code interpreter node and a whole bunch of others. As an example, let's add the calculator tool. So I'll simply drag it onto the canvas. It's attached to our agent, and if we save this flow and ask our agent a math question, like what is 2000 times 20 divided by 5? What you'll now notice is that we get this little icon in the response, and this indicates that a tool was called along with the tool name, which is the calculator tool in this instance. By clicking on this button, we can see the exact inputs that were passed to that tool and the tool output. Right, now let's add more tools to this agent. Let's add a tool that will provide the current date and time to our agent. Now, in the tool list, you will notice that there actually isn't a tool available to get the current date and time. We could use a custom tool, so this node over here, and that will allow us to write JavaScript code to get the current date and time. But we don't want to write any code, so what we'll do instead is go to Marketplace, then let's filter on tools, and within this list we get this tool called Get Current Date Time. So let's click on this, and if we scroll down we can see the JavaScript code for getting the current date and time. So let's click on Use Template, let's click on Add, and if we go to the Tools menu, we can now see that tool over here. And if we wanted to, we could make changes to this tool. For example, we might want to change the time zone to our time zone. But for this demo, I'll simply leave it as is. Let's go back to our chat flow. Let's go to our research agent. Then under add tools, let's go to the tool menu. Let's add the custom tool. And in this dropdown, we can see our current datetime tool over here. Now let's simply attach this to our agent under tools. And do take note, you can assign more than one tool to an agent. Let's save this and let's ask it, what is the current date and time? We can see that tool was indeed used, giving us our current date and time. This research agent isn't very useful at the moment, because if I ask it something like, what is OpenAI 03, it actually doesn't know, because the 03 model was only recently announced. So what we can do is add the ability for this agent to go online to retrieve up-to-date information. Let's click on Add Nodes, let's go to Tools, and let's add the SERP API tool. We can go ahead and attach this to the agent as well. And under credentials, let's click on create new. For the credential name, let's call this SERP API. And for the API key, go to serpapi.com, then click on register or sign into your account. From the dashboard, copy this key and add it to Flowise. Let's click on add, let's save this flow, and believe it or not, our agent will now have the ability to go online to get up-to-date information for us. So let's ask it again, what is OpenAI 03? And now we can see the search tool was indeed called, and the search query was OpenAI 03, along with the tool output. This answer is correct, and if we scroll down, we also get these citations. You now have a fully functional research agent. And of course, you can make this as complex as you want by adding additional tools. Just as a bonus tip, if you are using smaller open source models and you're not getting very good results, so perhaps the agent isn't selecting the right tool, you can improve the results by going to additional parameters on the agent and then providing some additional instructions. For example, when asked questions about math, use the calculator tool. Or perhaps if you're asked questions about recent events, use the search tool.